Hello students, in this chapter we see the how to expand the determinant of order 3, and the last 3 lectures we see the minus and cofactors. Okay. Now in this lecture we see the expansion of the determinant using minor and cofactors. Okay. Here, see carefully here, we know that how to expand the determinant of order 3. Okay. For example, we take a determinant. Okay. Here. We take a determinant, it is 1, 4, 2, 3, 1, 5, 1, 2, 1. Okay. Suppose it is a determinant. Now, we want to find the value of this determinant. Okay. Then, the expansion of this determinant, see carefully. Here, expansion along the first row. It is 1, 1 into determinant of. Eliminate the row and column of the element 1. And remaining term, it is 1, 5, 2, 1. Change the sign of the middle term, that is a minus 4 into determinant, it is a 3, 5, 1, 1, and then plus 2 into, okay, third number as it is, only change the sign of the middle term. When here it is a plus 4, we can write minus 4. When it is a minus 4, we can write here plus 4, and the first and third number as it is. It is a plus 1, we can write here plus 1. If it is a minus 1, we can write here minus 1. Okay, first and third as it is, only change the sign of the middle term. Now 2 into, it is a 3, 1, 1, 2. Okay, here, and calculate this. It is the expansion of the determinant. Okay, here. Now see carefully. Okay, here observe that 1 into this determinant, this determinant, it is 1, determinant of 1, 5, 2, 1. Okay, here it is a determinant obtained by deleting first row and first column. That means it is a minor of the element first row, first column. Here this determinant is minor of this element. Okay, here position it is a 1, 1. Okay, here it is a position 1, 2, and it is a position 1, 3. First row, first column, first row, second column, and it is first row, third column. Okay, here it is a position. Here this determinant obtained by deleting first row and first column, so it is the minor of the first row, first column element. The definition of minor: minor of an element of a determinant is the determinant obtained by deleting row and column of that element. Now here this determinant is the determinant obtained by deleting first row and first column. That means it is a minor. So we can write here, it is the first element 1, 1 into minor of 1, 1. Okay, here first element it is 1, 1 into minor of 1, 1. Minus 4 into, it is the second element. Again observe that it is determinant 3, 5, 1, 1. 3, 5, 1, 1. That means this determinant obtained by deleting first row and second column. That means this determinant, the value of this determinant, it is minor of first row, second column. Okay. Now it is minor of first row, second column. Okay. And then plus 2 into, here it is 3, 1, 1, 2. Okay. This determinant obtained deleting first row and third column. That means this determinant, it is a minor of first row, third column element. That means the minor of 2. Okay. Then it is minor of 1, 3. Okay. Here it is a minor of a element first row and first column. An element, it is a 1. Okay. Therefore it is 1 into minor of 1, 4 into minor of 4, and 2 into minor of 2. Okay, element 2 here, 1, 4, and 2. The element 1, whose position first row, first column. Then the value of determinant, it is 1 into minor of 1, it is 1. It is 4 into minor of 4, and 2 into minor of 2. But here change the sign of the middle term. Okay, here it is as it is plus, here it is a minus, and here it is a plus. Okay, plus minus, plus minus, that means we multiply by plus 1 or minus 1. And when we multiply the plus 1 and minus 1, and it is the definition of the cofactor, it is minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1 into minor of 1 1. C12, it is minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2 into minor of 1 2. And here C13, it is minus 1 to the power 1 plus 3 and into minor of 1 3. That means, see carefully here, that is, we can write C11 is equal to, C11 is equal to minus 1 to the power 2, that means it is a plus 1, plus 1, that means a minor 1 as it is. Here C12, it is minus 1 to the power 3, that means it is a minus 1, therefore it is a minus into minor of 1 2. And then C13, that is a cofactor of first row third column, it is minor of first row third column. Only change the sign of the first row second column element, that means this middle element, only sign. That means we can this write in the cofactor here, the minor of the element 1 1 is a cofactor as it is, but minor of element 1 2, it is a cofactor, but it is multiplied by minus 1, okay, because the addition of row number and column number is odd. Okay, here it is addition of row number and column number is even, so we can write minor and cofactor as it is. Here minor and cofactor changes only in the sign if the addition of the row number and column number is odd, like that. Okay, here these examples were detailed in the last lecture. Here watch carefully first our last lecture, minus and cofactors. Okay, here now see carefully, here it is M11, that means addition of row number and column number is same. It is 1 2, here addition of row number and column number is not same, so the here, sorry, it is odd. Okay, it is even, addition of row number and column number, it is even, so we cofactor it is as it is. That means M11 is equal to C11. Here addition of the row number and column number, it is odd, therefore minor of first row second column is equal to minus cofactor. Okay, and then here 1 3, again it is even, so as it is. So this can be written as, see carefully, it is 1 into C11 minus 4 into here minus C12 and plus 2 into C13, and then this can be written as 1 into C11 minus minus plus, it is a 4 into C12 and plus 2 into C13. Here it is a first row first column element, and then cofactor of each element, it is a 1 1, plus 4 into the cofactor of the 4 and plus 2 into the cofactor of 2. Okay, it is a determinant, okay, along the first row by using the cofactors. Okay, and here it is a first row first column element, we can generally denote it by, it is a A11 into C11 plus A12 into C12 and plus A13 into C13. Here it is a determinant. Okay, here you can find the determinant by using this expansion, but using the minors and cofactors, we can write directly determinant along here. It is a first row, it is a first row first column element, and multiply with the cofactor, first row second column and multiply with cofactor, first row third column and multiply its cofactor. Okay, here element and its cofactor multiplication, okay, and adding both, it is a determinant. Okay, see carefully, it is a determinant. Okay, it is expansion of determinant. Okay, the expansion of determinant madhe fakt evada lakshat rahu dya, kontahi ek row kiwa kontahi column ghya tumhi, tya element cha cofactor ani element ya donicha multiplication, plus puna row madla dusra element, tya element cha cofactor, donicha multiplication ani addition, एलिमेंट आणि त्याच एलिमेंटचा कोफॅक्टर, म्हणजे डिटरमिनंट काढण्यासाठी काय, हियर हा एलिमेंट 1 1 इंटू इट्स कोफॅक्टर, प्लस इट इज 4 4 इंटू इट्स कोफॅक्टर, प्लस इट इज 2 इंटू इट्स कोफॅक्टर. ओके, व्हेन वी टेक कोफॅक्टर्स, देर इज नो नीड टू द साइन, चेंज द साइन ऑफ द मिडल टर्म, इट इज ओनली फॉर द मायनर्स. ओके, व्हेन वी टेक कोफॅक्टर बोथ आर ऑल द प्लस. ओके, आपली डिटर्मिनंट काढण्याची मेथड काय? पहिला रो घेतला, ओके, मिडलचं साईन चेंज करतो. आता हे मिडलचं साईन कशामुळे चेंज करतो? ओके, आतापर्यंत आपण फर्स्ट लेक्चरमध्ये फक्त एवढं सांगितलं होतं की मिडलचं साईन चेंज करा. मिडलचं साईन कशामुळे चेंज करतो? तर इथं रो नंबर आणि कॉलम नंबरची ॲडिशन ऑड होती. रो नंबर आणि कॉलम नंबर, मग रो नंबर आणि कॉलम नंबरची ॲडिशन ऑड कुठं कुठं होती? हिअर हिअर वी कॅन राईट हिअर इट इज अ फर्स्ट एलिमेंट, इट इज अ प्लस मायनस प्लस मायनस प्लस मायनस अँड इट इज अ प्लस मायनस प्लस अल्टरनेटिव्ह साईन. ओके, हिअर ज्या ज्या ठिकाणी रो नंबर आणि कॉलम नंबरची ॲडिशन ऑड नंबर होती तिथं होणार ती मायनस. ओके, हिअर म्हणजे या नंबरला काय होणार? मायनस, आणि बाकी दोन ॲज इट इज. ओके, हिअर वी टेक द डिटर्मिनंट अलॉंग द सेकंड कॉलम. ओके, हिअर आता डिटर्मिनंट कोफॅक्टरचा यूज करून कसा काढायचा? तर कोणताही रो घ्या किंवा कोणताही कॉलम, त्या एलिमेंटला कोणताही रो किंवा कोणताही कॉलम काय करणार? पहिला रो घेतला तर एलिमेंट आणि त्याचा कोफॅक्टर या दोन्हीचा गुणाकार. ओके, एलिमेंट मल्टिप्लाय विथ इट्स कोफॅक्टर प्लस सेकंड एलिमेंट मल्टिप्लाय विथ इट्स कोफॅक्टर प्लस द थर्ड एलिमेंट मल्टिप्लाय विथ इट्स कोफॅक्टर. ओके, हिअर इट इज अ डिटर्मिनंट बाय युझिंग द कोफॅक्टर्स. ओके, सी केअरफुली अँड द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ डिटर्मिनंट. ओके, व्हॅल्यू ऑफ डिटर्मिनंट डायरेक्ट एक्सपॅन्शन करून काढा किंवा डायरेक्ट कोफॅक्टर यूज करून काढा, सेमच येणार. ओके, कारण या एक्सपॅन्शनवरूनच आपण हे लिहिलेले कोफॅक्टर्स. ओके, नाउ इट इज अलॉन्ग फर्स्ट रो. ओके, नाउ वी टेक अलॉन्ग सेकंड रो. ओके, सी केअरफुली द डिटर्मिनंट इट इज सेम डिटर्मिनंट 1 4 2 3 1 5 1 2 1. ओके, आता डिटर्मिनंटची व्हॅल्यू कशी काढणार? अलॉन्ग सेकंड रो, सेकंड रो कोणता आहे? इट इज 3 1 आणि 5. आता हिअर जेव्हा आपण फर्स्ट रो घेतो आणि तुम्ही हीच मेथड लक्षात राहू द्या, डिटर्मिनंट काढण्यासाठी तुम्ही फक्त एकच मेथड लक्षात राहू द्या. हे फक्त तुम्हाला याच्यासाठी सांगायलो की एक्स डिटर्मिनंट तुम्हाला फक्त फर्स्ट रोच नाही तर तुम्ही तिन्ही रो आणि तिन्ही कॉलम घेऊन डिटर्मिनंट काढू शकता. ओके, हिअर टू फाइंड द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ द डिटर्मिनंट वी यूज फर्स्ट रो सेकंड रो ऑर थर्ड रो ऑर फर्स्ट कॉलम सेकंड कॉलम ऑर थर्ड कॉलम. वी कॅन फाइंड द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ द डिटर्मिनंट बाय युजिंग द 6 मेथड्स. ओके, अलॉन्ग फर्स्ट रो, अलॉन्ग सेकंड रो, अलॉन्ग थर्ड रो, अलॉन्ग फर्स्ट कॉलम, अलॉन्ग सेकंड कॉलम अँड अलॉन्ग थर्ड कॉलम. ओके, हिअर आता ही मेथड सगळ्यात मेन. ओके, तुम्ही हेच लक्षात राहू द्या. ओके, फक्त हेच दुसऱ्या मेथडनं सांगतो. आता इथं काय करत होतो आपण? हिअर वन इन टू इट इज अ डिटर्मिनंट. ओके, वन इन टू डिलीट द रो अँड कॉलम, डिलीट द रो अँड कॉलम ऑफ द वन अँड टेक द डिटर्मिनंट, चेंज द साईन ऑफ द मिडल टर्म. ओके, देन 4 इन टू अगेन डिलीट रो अँड कॉलम अँड ऑप्टेन डिटर्मिनंट, देन कॅल्क्युलेट इट इज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ दिस डिटर्मिनंट. नाव वी कॅन टेक अराउंड द सेकंड रो. नाव हिअर इन द सेकंड रो हिअर इट इज अ पोझिशन 2 1 2 2 अँड इट इज अ 2 3. सेकंड रो फर्स्ट कॉलम, सेकंड रो सेकंड कॉलम अँड सेकंड रो थर्ड कॉलम. हिअर ॲडिशन ऑफ द रो नंबर अँड कॉलम नंबर हिअर इट इज अ ऑड, सो हिअर चेंज द साईन ऑफ द फर्स्ट अँड थर्ड नंबर. ओके, हिअर वी चेंज द साईन ऑफ द मिडल टर्म, बट हिअर वी चेंज द साईन ऑफ द फर्स्ट अँड थर्ड नंबर बिकॉज द ॲडिशन ऑफ द रो नंबर अँड कॉलम नंबर ऑफ दॅट एलिमेंट इट इज ऑड, सो हिअर वी गेट मायनस. सो हिअर इट इज अ प्लस 3, वी कॅन राईट मायनस 3. मायनस 3 इंटू डिटर्मिनंट ऑफ, मायनस 3 इंटू डिटर्मिनंट ऑफ इलिमिनेट द रो अँड कॉलम. प्रोसिजर सेम, तुम्ही हे मायनस 3 घ्यायले, 3 ने मल्टिप्लाय करायला अलॉन्ग सेकंड रो. कोणताही एलिमेंट घेतला की काय करणार? त्याचा रो आणि कॉलम सोडून द्या. उरलं काय? 4 2 2 1 4 2 2 1. देन हिअर सेकंड रो मध्ये मिडल ॲज इट इज, कारण हे प्लस आहे. ओके, तेव्हा मायनस प्लस मायनस. देन अगेन सेम, या वनचा रो आणि कॉलम सोडून द्या. 1 2 1 1 1 2 1 1 अँड हिअर चेंज द साईन ऑफ द लास्ट टर्म, दॅट इज इट, सॉरी इट इज 5. इट इज 5 अँड अगेन सेम डिलीट द रो अँड कॉलम 1 4 1 2 1 4 1 2 अँड हिअर the value of the determinant by using this method or by using this method is the same. Okay, here we can calculate this. Okay, see carefully here. Here it is a definition we can write after the expansion of this determinant here. Now we expand this. It is 1 into 1 minus 10, 1 minus 10, minus 4 into 3 minus 5, 3 minus 5, and plus 2 into 6 minus 1. Now calculate. It is minus 9, minus 9 into 1, minus 9. It is minus 2, minus 2 into minus 4, plus 8. And here, 5 into plus 2, it is a 10. Okay. And then the value of the determinant, see carefully. Here it is a minus 1 and plus 10, it is a 9. Okay, here it is the value of this determinant. Now, we can find the value of this determinant here by using the first row. Okay, here, finding the value of determinant along first row. Now, finding the value of again same determinant by using the second row. Okay, and then see carefully here, it is a minus 3 into 4 minus 4, 4 minus 4, plus 1 into 1 minus 2, it is 1 and it is minus 2, and minus 5 into 2 minus 4, 2 and minus 4. See carefully here, it is 0, so it is 0. Here it is a minus 1, and here it is minus 2, minus 2 into minus 5, it is a plus 10, and then it is a 9. Now, the value of the determinant along first row or along second row is the same, or we can find also the along third row. Okay, in the third row, here take first element plus, second minus, and it is third again plus, and multiply with these three numbers in the third row. We take a one determinant by deleting the row and column of that element here. Okay, here same. Now you can find the determinant by using suppose one column. Here we can find the value of again this determinant. Determinant it is, see carefully, it is 1, 4, 2. 3, 1, 5, and 1, 2, 1. 1, 2, 4, 3, 1, 5, and 1, 2, 1. Now, we find the determinant along first column. Okay, here, see carefully. In the first column, there is 1, 3, and 1. And procedure is same. Here, in the first row, we take 1, 4, and 2. And then multiply with 1, the determinant obtained by deleting the row and column of 1. Multiply with 4, we obtain the determinant by deleting row and column of 4. And again, for the third element, we multiply with 2 by deleting the row and column of the number 2. These are the determinant. And we change the sign, that means the multiply by 1 or minus 1 of these three numbers. Okay. We multiply the 1 by plus 1, that means as it is. We multiply by 4 by minus 1 because the addition of the row number and column number is odd. So here it is a minus 4. Here it is 4, we can take minus 4. Again, here addition of row number and column number it is even. So we multiply this number by plus 1. So it is a plus 2. Okay. Now, along the first column, there are the three numbers. 1, 3 and 1. Here it is a position, first row first column, second row first column, and it is a third row first column. That means here first row first column, row addition of the row number and column number it is even, so we multiply this number it plus 1. Here addition is a odd number, so we multiply these three number by minus 1, and we multiply this one by plus 1, and we take a one determinant with multiple with this 1, 3 and 1. Here determinant obtained by deleting row and column by that element. Okay, here determinant, it is a 1 along the first column, it is a plus 1. 1 into determinant of delete row and column, therefore 1 5 2 1. Then change the sign of this term, because addition of the row number and column number, it is minus. Addition of row number and column is odd, so we multiply by minus. And then here 4 2 2 1, and then this one as it is, it is a plus 1 into 4 2 1 5. Okay, here 4 2 1 5, and now expand it is 1 into 1 minus 10, 1 minus 10, minus 3 into 4 minus 4, and plus 1 into 20 minus 2. Then it is minus 9, so it is minus 9, it is a 0, and here it is 18, it is a plus 18, and again it is 9. Okay, here to find the value of determinant along any row or any one column. Okay, first row, second row, third row, first column, second column, or third column. Okay, now it is along the first column, again we can find the determinant along the second column. Okay, in the second column there are the three element, 4 1 and 2. Here its position, it is 1 2, its position, it is a 2 2, and its position 3 2. Okay, here we can find the determinant along the second column. Okay, here the second column, it is a 4 as it is, sorry, here change the sign of the 4, because the addition of the row number and column number, it is odd, so it will be minus, it is plus, and it is minus, minus plus minus. Okay, therefore it is a minus 4 into determinant of, minus 4 into determinant of, delete the row and column of the element 4, row and column, we get 3 5 1 1. Then this second as it is, plus 1, multiply this 1 by plus 1, multiply 4 by minus 1, multiply 2 by minus 2. Okay, again now multiply with 1, it is 1 2 1 1, 1 2 1 1, and then last it is a minus 2 into delete the row and column of that element, we get 1 2 3 5, 1 2 3 5. And then it is minus 4 into 3 minus 5, 3 minus 5, plus 1 into here 1 minus 2, minus 2 into 5 minus 6, 5, and it is minus 6. And then it is minus 2, see carefully, minus 2 into minus 4, it is a plus 8, here it is a minus 1, and again here minus 5 minus 6, it is a minus 1, minus 1 into minus 2, it is a plus 2, and it is 9. Okay, that means we find the value of the determinant by using, okay, any row or any column. We can find the value of the determinant along any one row or any one column, the value remains same. Okay, that means there are the 6 methods to find the value of the determinant. 6 methods to find the value of the determinant, but to calculate the value of determinant, we can use the only one, that is the first row method. Okay, apan calculation karte vel fakt ya pahilya method chach use karnare determinant kadayla, fakt bakicha lakshat rahu de ki tumhala baki method na sudha determinant kadta yete. Okay, ani kontane determinant kadla, pahila row ghun kada, dusra row ghun kada, kiwa tisra row ghun kada, kiwa pahila dusra tisra column. Okay, कोणत्याही डिटर्मिनंट काढा, डिटर्मिनंटची व्हॅल्यू सेम येते, फक्त साईन घेते वेळेस हियर आपण काय करतो, पहिला नंबर ॲज इट इज, दुसरा नंबर ॲज इट इज, ॲज इट इज म्हणजेच काय, त्याला 1 ने मल्टिप्लाय करा, दॅट इज द प्लस 1 ने मल्टिप्लाय, अँड हियर सेकंड नंबरचं साईन चेंज करतो, साईन चेंज करणं म्हणजेच काय, मायनस 1 ने मल्टिप्लाय करणं, मग हे मायनस 1 ने मल्टिप्लाय केलं. ओके, देन मग फर्स्ट रो नुसार हा आला डिटर्मिनंट, आणि हीच मेथड लक्षात राहू द्या, आपण हीच मेथड यूज करणार आहे डिटर्मिनंट काढण्यासाठी. ओके, फक्त ह्याही मेथड लक्षात राहू द्या, ओके की या मेथडने सुद्धा आपल्याला डिटरमिनंट काढता येते ओके अलोंग ऑल थ्री रोज और ऑल थ्री कॉलम्स फक्त साइन लक्षात राहू द्या ओके आणि साइन कशावर आहेत त्याच्या पोझिशनवर आहेत ओके पोझिशनवर आहेत हे लक्षात राहू द्या अल्टरनेटिव्ह प्लस मायनस फक्त प्लस स्टार्टिंग घ्या अँड देन अल्टरनेटिव्ह प्लस मायनस प्लस मायनस प्लस मायनस ओके हियर नाउ दीज आर द सिक्स मेथड्स टू फाइंड द डिटर्मिनंट दॅट इज द एक्सपान्शन ऑफ द डिटर्मिनंट नाउ वी कॅन राईट द जनरल फॉर्म्युला फॉर हियर वी टेक अ स्पेसिफिक एक्झाम्पल्स वी कॅन फाइंड राईट द जनरल फॉर्म्युला फॉर द एक्सपान्शन ऑफ डिटर्मिनंट बाय युजिंग मायनर अँड को फॅक्टर्स ओके हियर Now, you can write this sixth method in a general form. Okay, here we take a determinant here A11, that is the first row, first column element, A12, A13, A21, A22. A23, A31, A32, and it is A33. Okay. Now, here the value of determinant along. It is a determinant. Along. First row. Okay, here. Determinant is equal to, see carefully, the element multiply with its cofactor A11 into C11 plus the element multiply with its cofactor and plus the element multiply with its cofactor. Okay, here. It is the value of this determinant. Along the first row. Now, along second row. Determinant is equal to second row here. A21 element multiply with its cofactor plus A22 into C22 plus A23 into C23. Okay. The value of determinant we take along first row, second row, or third row. Okay. Here, method is the element multiply with its cofactor plus second element multiply with its cofactor and third element multiply with its cofactor and adding them. Okay. Now, along the third row. Here, determinant is equal to A31 into C31 plus A32 into C32 plus A33 into C33. Okay, element multiply with its cofactor plus element multiply with its cofactor plus element multiply with cofactor. Okay, in any row. Okay, or any column. Okay, here now along column, along first column. Okay, here the determinant is equal to, see carefully, the first column A11, A21, and A3. So here A11 into its cofactor plus the second element in first column, it is A21, and it is C21 plus A31 into C31. Here A11, A21 and A31 are the elements in the first column, and each element multiply with its cofactor and adding them, it is the determinant. Okay, now along the second column, here A12, second column, okay, C12 plus A22, C22 plus A32, C32, and last along the third column, determinant, it is A13 into C13 plus A23 into C23 plus A33 and plus C33. Okay, these are the six way to find the value of the determinant. Okay, we are use only the first method to finding the determinant of order 3. Okay, here these are the six ways to find the value of the determinant. Okay, see carefully this. It is the in the general form. We take the A11, A12, A13, all the nine elements. Okay, we can take any real numbers and then find the value of this determinant. Okay, here it is the six ways. See carefully. We can use only this first method.